So last unit, we talked about HTTPS, how to use the transport layer security protocols to first do a handshake, to agree on a secret key, and then to have a secure channel between a client and a server. What these messages are, we just drew as arrows, but what they really are, if we think about the internet, well, they're messages going through routers on the internet. And there may be many hops between the client and the server. And along these hops will go packets. Because they're using TLS, part of the packet is the encrypted message, but another part of the packet is the routing information. This is necessary so R1 knows the direction to send the message. It needs to know that the goal is to reach the server. So any eavesdropper who can see one of these messages, and it could be the first one from the client to the first router, or maybe she's intercepting a message on some later routing path, well, she can learn that the client and the server are talking to each other. This is a form of traffic analysis where the important property we want to hide is not the contents of the message, which if HTTPS is working correctly, are encrypted and cannot be understood by Eve. But what we really want to hide is the fact that this client is talking to this server or that Alice is talking to Bob. The mere presence of communication between two parties is often enough to cause problems. An example would be if the client is a dissident in some oppressive country and is connecting to a server that's used by dissidents to communicate, or a server in another country that's viewed as a threat. So if we want to prevent this kind of traffic analysis, we want to prevent adversaries who can observe messages on the routers from being able to know which parties are communicating, we need to do something else.